They are all the way from San Francisco in the US of A. Here, gracing the land of green and gold with their presence for the first time ever. They are the unconventional. They are the uncategorizable. They are Mr. Bungle. And let's right now go and see if they'll let us into their world of the bizarre and the macabre. Come this way.
Hello, my name is Trey, from Mr. Bungle.
I am Bear, and I wear trendy glasses.
I'm feeling that.
So, I'd like to talk to Mr. Bungle of Masks. Are you embarrassed by something?
Just to be with each other, mostly.
Really?
Yeah. Not actually embarrassed at anything that we're performing.
No, I wouldn't be.
Wouldn't all want to be seen in one place at one time.
But that's the thing. And that's why you're staying in different hotels while you're here.
Well, this many Americans at once is pretty embarrassing, no matter how you do it. I mean, five on a basketball court, that's not that bad. There's six or seven of us on stage.
Yeah.
Kind of pushing it.
Are you happy with your name as a band, Mr. Bungle?
No.
Did you ever want to change that?
Yes.
How come?
That's the name of a group, like when you're, you know, 60, 65 and you want to have a big band reunion, you call it Mr. Bungle.
See, Mr. Bungle is actually a character, a cartoon character, who helps us learn how to comb our hair. This is very, very much like a UFO we're sitting on here. Disco Volante, in Italian, means flying disc. Have you ever been abducted?
Technically, no.
Don't mean you had.
No, that's Theo.
Yeah, Theo has absolutely been abducted.
Right. How do you know?
Picked up because of his disappearance for, I think it was 5 to 6 hours.
Oh, really?
After a band rehearsal one night. And we were all out on my lawn, and the next thing he remembered, he sort of disappeared. The next thing he remembered was waking up at home, which is 7 miles away, kind of in the country.
And he disappears every once in a while now, but it's more his choice. He just kind of
You don't know that. That could be, you know, part of his daily job.
Do you want to talk about vocals?
Yeah, we can.
Really?
Yeah.
How much do you like explaining?
Yeah. Let's talk about vocals.
As a group, the sounds of what the voice can do.
A lot. We try to use it as an instrument.
That's cool.
Yeah. And Mike is willing to do as much as the rest of us, you know, as far as manipulating sounds and doing all that kind of stuff.
It's really hard to talk to a shirt. We've moved through 2 albums here, we've moved through Mr. Bungle and then Disco Volante. Can the fans keep up?
Probably not.
Do you mind?
Well, there's a lot of different kinds of fans.
Mm.
There's a lot of different varieties of people in the world.
Who like Mr. Bungle?
Yeah, some do, some don't. And they'll always be changing, and that's really great.
So it is an evolving process. Even the fan base is evolving.
Yeah, always.
What about the music?
The second album's the hardest.
I think the second is the hardest. That's sophomoric effort.
How come it was so hard?
It wasn't hard, but it has a reputation of being the difficult one to get over.
He always, that's the experimental progressive record that has nothing really worth listening on it usually.
So we have that grace period there, 3 or 4 years. Most bands are forced to put it out within a year or so, and they don't really have enough time to either match what they had on the first one or to come up with something new.
Of course, yeah. That doesn't mean we were working on it all that time.
Yeah. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.